Hi there, welcome to the channel. My name is Alana and I'm the creator of the Health Analytic Insights podcast, where I interview guests and talk all things health informatics. In this video, I'm going to go over common interview questions that I have heard in my interviews for health informatics roles. And through interviewing and going over countless job posts, I have noticed some common similarities and trends in the types of questions that are often asked in these interview interviews. So in this video, I'm going to give a list of the interview questions and some of my responses on how I would answer these common interview questions. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Some common interview questions I've heard are, what would you do if a clinician came into your office and immediately wanted you to build a report ASAP? And also, how would you prioritize demands from different organizations for reporting needs? And so with these questions, what the interview is probably trying to test is your ability to prioritize different requests, and if you have tools or systems in place to ensure that deadlines are being met. These could be like if you have knowledge of tools like Microsoft Planner, Jira, SharePoint, because you don't want to get into a situation where you're only serving one department and another department has not received any reports or requests. So you want to make sure that you are keeping your manager in the loop, keeping your coworkers in the loop of the reports or requests that you're working on, and ensuring that you're keeping deadlines and keeping on track of your requests. So other questions that I've received are, what is the difference between prevalence or incidence? And give examples of how sensitivity and specificity are used in healthcare. In addition, I've received questions on, do I have any experience in data visualization tools? How do I communicate insights to a non-technical background? And what large-scale clinical data sets have I worked with? And what challenges did I take from this? So all of these questions kind of test my technical skills, because oftentimes you'll see that health informatics roles usually are looking for people who have a background in biostatistics or health informatics. So oftentimes you'll need that statistics knowledge. And also they want to know what type of experience you have working with unstructured data, because oftentimes in school you can really deal with clean, pristine data. And in the real world, especially in the healthcare, that's not true. Oftentimes data is messy and unstructured. So they might want to know your experience working with, you know, difficult date formats or names that are formatted incorrectly. So some other questions that I have received are, give examples of how you worked in a team environment. How do you deal with conflict among colleagues? And why do you want to work for this organization? Why do you want to work in the healthcare field specifically? So with these questions, again, working in the health informatics profession, you oftentimes work in a multidisciplinary environment. You could be having conversations with IT one day and then clinical staff another day. You're working with developers, clinicians, midwives, doctors, nurses, a whole gamut of people, and they want to know that you have the ability to take into consideration all these different opinions and all these different perspectives in order to improve your work. And so they want to know if you have any experience working in these team environments and how you dealt with, you know, different perspectives and different viewpoints. So to summarize, some of the patterns that I've seen when it comes to these job postings in health informatics are understanding of clinical terminology, experience dealing with large clinical data sets, experience with writing SQL queries, experience with data visualization tools such as Power BI, Excel, Tableau, Qlik, experience working in a multidisciplinary environment, and experience with a health discipline. And so many of the questions stem from these requirements that I often see with health informatics roles. So I would love to hear from you. What questions have you received in your health informatics job positions? Did I nail them? Did I miss some? Again, I'd love to hear from you. Comment down below. And again, I have a free guide for starting your career in health informatics, and that will be in the description box below as well. Thank you so much for listening, and have a wonderful day.